Yeah, dear student, welcome back to my another class of accountancy. Our chapter going on is retirement of the partner, and topic going on is computation of amount due to retiring partner. Here again, we are going to solve one comprehensive numerical, and here the payment to the retiring partner is done in three different ways. Okay, remember my words. Payment to the retiring partner is done in three different ways. Okay, how that I will tell you. So first of all, we are going to make working notes. But before this, we are going to read additional information. See here, Z retire on 1st April 16 on the following terms. Goodwill of the firm was valued at 30,000. So we will make the working note. Value of patent is to be reduced by 20% and that of machinery to 90%. So that will go to the debit of revaluation. Provision for doubtful debt was to be raised to 6%. This will also go to the debit of revaluation. Liability for workmen compensation is to be created to the extent of 6,000. So WCR is given, so that you will subtract it and remaining is transferred to the partner's capital. Z took over investment and market value. Here the retiring partner has taken an asset. And the value of the investment given is 15,000 in the balance sheet, while market value is 17,600. So here there is a profit of 2,600 that will go to the credit side of revaluation account. So there are two important things in this numerical. First, retiring partner has taken an asset and the payment to the retiring partner is done in three different ways that we will discuss today. So see, first we are going to make working notes. Three partners, X, Y, Z. The ratio is 3:1. Old ratio. Clear? Z is retiring. New ratio is not given. Clear? So that will be a new ratio. And as I told you in the starting of the chapter, if no information is given, the new ratio will be their gaining ratio. So gaining ratio will remain same. Okay. Now here, see, one goodwill is given on the asset side of the balance sheet. It's a loss. So it will be written off in the old profit sharing ratio and in the old partner. Goodwill of the firm is, goodwill of the firm is 30,000. So Z will get 30,000 into 1/6. That comes to 5,000. Okay. That will be borne by 5,000 will be borne by X and Y in the gaining ratio. But first of all, we will write out existing goodwill. So X, Y, Z, capital account debit. To goodwill. So the old goodwill is 6,000. So 3:1. Clear? You will write the addition. Being the existing goodwill written off. Clear? Now you will pass entry for the share of amount payable to the Z. Again, X capital account debit, Y capital account debit to Z's capital. So the amount payable to the Z is 5,000 by the name of goodwill. Again, you will write an addition, being the amount of or being the share of goodwill given to the retiring partner. Okay. In this way, your working notes are over. The valuation account is to be prepared by you as usual, and there is a loss of revaluation of 4,800. Now, in your numerical, you have to make partner's capital account of all the three partners plus balance sheet. But here, I am making capital account only of the retiring partner. So we are going to prepare. Now after working notes, you will write the word solution, put a colon mark, and now you will make. So first we are going to make Z capital account. Yes, here I am preparing that paper. So the opening balance given by parents, DD, opening balance given of Z is 21,000. Clear? Now afterwards, we will give workman compensation reserve. So the balance of workman compensation given is 12,000 and after 12,000 there is a liability of 6,000. So 6,000 will be distributable and the ratio of that is 1 by 6. So that comes to 1,000. EPF will not distribute. Afterward is by investment fluctuation reserve, by IFR account. So IFR is 6,000. Again 1 by 6, 1,000 will belong to Z. Clear? Now give the share of goodwill by X capital and by Y capital. How much is getting? 3,000 and 2,000. Clear? Now the liability side of the balance sheet is over. Everything is distributed. WCR as well as IFR. Now see, on the asset side, is there any loss given? Yes, loss is given. Existing goodwill is given and advertisement expenditure is given. So first you will write to advertisement expenditure account, that is given as 3600. So the share of that will come to 600. Now share of goodwill, existing goodwill, this means it's a loss. It will come to the debit side of Z capital account. That comes to 6,000, again 1,000. Okay. Now there is a revaluation loss, so that will also come to the debit side of capital account. That comes to 800. Now here Z has also taken an investment, so write to investment account. Here Z has taken investment of 17,600. Okay. This we have made, all items are written on the credit side as well as on the debit side. Okay. Now what question is saying, that the amount payable to the Z is settled on following basis: 50% in cash and 50% of the balance within 1 year and balance by a bill of exchange. Now how to find out? So in order to find out, we will make a total of both the sides. I am erasing this. Total of the credit side of the Z is 23 plus 5, 26,000. And on the debit side, it is 20,000. Clear? So amount payable to Z is 26,000 credit minus debit, that is 20,000. That comes to 6,000. Sorry, that is 28. Total is 28. 28,000 minus 20,000. So payable balance is 28, while debit balance is 28. Total amount payable to the Z is now 8,000. Now this, out of this 8,000, 50% is paid in cash. So to cash account, 50% of 8,000 is 4,000. Clear? Cash payment of 4,000. The remaining is 4,000. And out of this 50%, is transferred to his loan account. So 50% of 4,000 is 2,000. And for the balance, receivable is issued. Clear? So on the debit side, first you will write to cash account balance payment, to Z's loan account 2000 and to bills payable account. In this way, the final payment is done to the Z. I am again repeating, total of credit side is 20,000 and total of debit side is 20,000. You have to make total payment of 8,000 to Z. Out of that, what we are saying, 50% is paid in cash, subtract 50% to cash account. Now, left is 4,000. Out of this, what we are saying, the balance is transferred, 50% is transferred to his loan account. 50% of 4,000 is 2,000. And for the balance amount, bills payable is given. So in this way, his account is settled. Clear? Now, but we have to make partners capital account of all the three partners, and I am preparing balance sheet over here. For your reference, I will upload the numerical, don't worry about that. See, first creditors, workmen compensation claim, EPF, always remember EPF is outside liability that is never distributable amongst the partners. Bills payable, Z's loan account, and in the last, capital account. Capital and Y capital. Creditors are 21,000, claim is of 6,000, EPF again 6,000, bills payable is of 2,000, Z loan account 2,000, capital account X 63,800 and Y 29,200. It comes to 93,000. Total is 1,30,000. On the asset side, see cash 5,750 you already had, out of which 4,000 you have done payment to the Z, left with you is 1,750. Debtors 40,000 less provision 2,400, that is 37,600. Stock 37,650. Patents 8,000 and machinery 45,000. Make a total that comes to 1,30,000. Okay. In this way, this numerical is completed. Now, as the adjustment of capital has been removed from your syllabus, So retirement of the partner is completed. We will solve one or two more comprehensive numerical. Afterward, we will start death of the partner. Thank you. Happy learning.